All right, welcome back. I couldn't resist trying to download and load an animated GIF, and it did work very nicely. So you can see a little Pikachu GIF animating up in the upper right hands of the screen, but it did import a lot of frames. So this is the animation side of Piskel, which is actually really excellent. We've got each individual drawing here where I can switch to them. You can see nothing is happening between these two because for some reason this GIF had multiple still frames and I wasn't able to adjust the frame rate. And so that's just for timing reasons, but here it shifts, right? So the whole feature moves. We've got the ears are moving, the tail is moving. We do have an onion skin option, which is interesting. If you click on one frame, you can sort of see a ghostly representation of the previous frame. This doesn't look as nice when you've got a nice finished file like this. It's better when you've got just flat colors filled in, moving around before you get to all this detail, because then it's much easier to see what the changes are. But it is a nice feature for animation. So you can see him squishing down there little by little. On each one of these frames, we have a few options. We can delete the frame entirely. We can duplicate the frame to get a second copy of it, and I believe it places it right underneath. Let's find out. So if I click this one, so that one's a change. That means if I click this, yeah. So it just created number four here, which effectively would slow that section down a little bit. We can delete them, and we can rearrange them by clicking and dragging and just dragging them somewhere else. Okay. So those are all nice features. You can see if you were able to plan through all of this motion and carefully adjust the figure, you can get really nice motion like this. But that's going to be pretty unlikely because this is a very complicated motion. You'd have to probably already have a little bit of an animation plan or some animation experience in mind. This thing not only does his idle, but then he also does a little cute tail wag at the end there. This is not the only option I was given for importing. Oh, I don't want to export. I want to import. So I used the Browse Images option, selected this, which is from Giphy, and it had a transparent background. Hit open. As a single image gave me the animation. So I didn't set the resize options. They were just set by default. I suppose you could set them. Smooth resize, good luck. Resizing pixel art can be weird. I wouldn't vouch that this is going to go well, but you could try it. But we also have import as sprite sheet, which I thought was interesting. This is a single frame, right, set to 540 by 300. If I click next now, see what happens. We could combine it with what we already have or replace. We really should just replace, but this is going to be a pretty large file, I believe. Let's see. It didn't seem to do anything. I was expecting a large grid, and I'm not sure what happened. So I'm going to create a new sprite just to see, for the sake of argument, what's going to happen. By the way, when you try to close a Piskel file, it'll ask you, "Are you sure?" I am sure. Here's a new one. Let me try one more time. Import, browse. Let's go down to that Pikachu GIF. I want a sprite sheet. Import. See what it does. So we'll replace. That's fine. It just gave me an animation either way. So I was expecting to get a grid sheet, but we didn't. So I guess that's fine. Anyway, you can open existing animated GIFs and then mess with them and add things to them if you want. One feature I will show here because it's more convenient with an animation that's already running is the clone to all layers feature. So I'm going to create a new layer and I'm going to place it beneath Pikachu. I'll choose this blue option and then I'm just going to draw. Wow, with a much larger brush, apparently. This is a very large. So for some reason, this is imported not at the default pixel size, but at whatever the preview size was. So there's a number of things we probably want to do to this if we wanted to actually use it as pixel art. But I'm just going to scribble this thing behind Pikachu's head. You'll probably see it flash blue on the preview for just one frame at some point. There it is. Just did it. But if I wanted this to be a permanent background, like we wanted to add something behind the character, or maybe a separate object that was animating with the character, now I could choose clone current layer to all frames. And now that blue stripe that I drew is back there forever. It's just the background of this animating Pikachu. We could also use the move tool now. So we've got control apply to all layers or shift apply to all frames. So right now, if I just move this blue stripe without holding either of those, it's going to shift at some point in the middle of the animation. I think it's going to hop. There it goes. Boom. Out of the way. So I'm going to undo that. There we go. Took a second to think about it. So instead, if I do shift, apply to all frames, this blue stripe now I could place on the lower portion of Pikachu, and it'll just animate stably throughout. That means that I could also, let's see, what can I do? All frames, it won't let me grab, oh yeah, it will let me grab all layers. Control and shift, let me try both at the same time. Control and shift, so I should be able to grab the entire Pikachu animation. Yep, and we could slide it over here. It takes a second to think because it's got 117 frames, or what is it, 112 frames to think about. So it is a lot of work for it to do this, but it can do all of those kinds of things. Let me make a new one, though, to demonstrate actual animation procedure. So I'm going to shrink my brush way down again. And we'll just select some bright color that we can view easily, so that it's red. So I'm going to actually make a quick animation here just to show that we can do it. I'll put a little circle up here. You can see it in the preview, but we can't even see it in the thumbnail because it's behind the number. And I'll add a new frame. And we have onion skin turned on right now. So what we're seeing is nothing without it on and a little ghostly dot with it on. And then this just flashes on and off, on and off. So I'm going to make this kind of just zip around the screen. So I'll draw a slightly larger size right here, make a new frame, draw a much bigger streak kind of going this way, another frame, and I'll draw a smaller, more clustered shape right here, and then finally I'll have it land right there. If I wanted to hold this in that position, that's when I have to duplicate a frame. So I'll duplicate 2, 3, 4 like that. So now you can see this thing pops over there and then holds still. Okay. I'll make a new frame to start accelerating this thing downward like this. A new frame, and I'll start to zip it really quickly off in this direction. A new frame, and I'll try to make it come back up to where it started again. And new frame. So I can't see where I'm aiming now. So I'm going to duplicate this first frame and then drag it all the way to the end. See wherever that is. Keep going. Come on. Okay, right to the end here. So now this is the most recently drawn frame. This is a frame with nothing, and this is my ending position that I'm shooting for, right? So I'm going to do an in-between, which would be an elongated frame that's not quite as long as the previous one, kind of like this. I'm going to start thickening the end there. I will make a new frame and put it between the end and here. So I wanted one more, right? So now we've got this. So I can have a slightly elongated kind of cushioning frame, and then it arrives, and then I'll duplicate this one two more times. So I've got four. There we go. So now we can see in the preview we've got a dot that holds in two different positions and zips between two different positions, and that animation preview is playing really nicely. Okay, so that would be an example of like an animation procedure. If I then wanted to add additional details, I could do it on this existing layer or add a layer. So just for the sake of argument, let me add a layer, and this will be for like little sparkles or something. I'm going to use the same color, but I'm going to set the layer's opacity to like 0.5. And so going all the way back up again, all of these animation layers still exist for this layer. At the start here, I'll just have nothing. And then as it starts to move, I'll put in more and more little sparkles that kind of appear around the figure as it moves and then drift off and disappear. So I'm not going to put an extra detail in that one. So this one as well. And so now we should see Yeah, some little sprinkly bits, and it's a little hard to see, but I can open the preview. Some little bits kind of going away, and they're also half opacity, so if we had this on a background, they'd be harder to spot. Or I could do them in white or something like that to make them look like magic sparkles or whatever. But I could do that, all of that work on a second layer. We could add a background on yet another layer, or some driving object, like a little item that is trailing this line to it on yet another layer, whatever we want to do. Okay. So that's briefly the animation feature here. I'm not going to go into the mechanics of animation in this video. Just wanted to show you how that would work and how you would attempt to create an animation. I will show you the export options, though. In export, we have the option to make a sheet. So we could do a sprite sheet in 4x4 rows because we have 16 frames. So a sprite sheet is every single entire canvas in its own separate area. And so that would give us a 128x128 pixel image that we could interpret through Unity or another animation or game engine in order to reconstruct this animation. Or we could just have an animated GIF that we had. I don't know if Unity in particular can import animated GIFs as animation sheets. I suspect maybe not, but it definitely can deal with this sort of thing. Also, the zip option, which is to just put one PNG for every frame in an entire zip folder, that would work as well. Unity can deal with either one of those. Okay? So just so that you know, those are your export options for an animation.